Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you doing this fine day? Me? I'm slightly overcome. A little bit. I've got a technology crush happening right now. Our friends at Evernote have hit one home run in the past, as far as I'm concerned. The Evernote Web Clipper is a tool which I think is one of the best tools ever created. It's changed my life. They might have done it again. I've probably used 735 different scanning apps on my smartphone. Different apps to capture documents. Well, Evernote has released Scannable, and I got a tech crush going on. It is blowing me away. Why? Stick around, and I'll show you today on Dotto Tech. Now, I'm not one to gush all that often about a piece of technology. I expect them to perform really well. But when something is released, especially in a space that you've used it a lot, that you've worked in a lot in the past, and they delight you because they really have looked at what's going on in the marketplace and figured it out, that is worth celebrating and is worth getting a little bit excited about. And Evernote might have done that with Scannable. It's still early. I've only been using it for a couple of days. The reason that it's been out for a little over a week, I think. But I was waiting for my brand new iPhone 6 Plus, the huge one. Look at the size of that thing. It's bigger than my head. I was waiting for it to arrive before I started to play with this because my old 4S just wasn't up to the task. Unfortunately, once again, for our Android cousins, this product released out of the gate is only for iPhone, iOS, tablet, the iPad, and the iPhone. Sorry, guys. But it's going to be worth waiting for, just like other tools that Evernote has released. It's certainly going to be great when it comes on in the Android world as well. So what is it? It's basically a scanning app that allows you to capture documents really quickly and easily. And as I said before, I've used dozens of these different apps in the past, but Scannable, oh my gosh. Watch how quickly it just kind of gets it. It's a single purpose. It's designed to capture scans of documents, business cards, receipts, you name it, it will capture it. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to launch it here, and I'm going to show you quickly how awesome it is. So there's my Evernote notebook. Do you see what it's doing? It parsed out where the information was, captured it, and has stored it for me already. Just that quickly, it found the information. Now, I'm looking here on my screen. On your screen, it looks a little bit blurry. I think it's because I'm using a wireless connection here. But my screen, it looks fantastic. So it's completely readable, ready to work within Evernote. And you'll see once I save it into Evernote. So that was just a note captured from one of my Evernote notebooks. But this could as easily be a document, a contract, pretty much any document that you want to capture. Now, what do you want to do with a document once you capture it? Well, they give us a variety of different options. Now, first of all, if we look at the three little dots down at the bottom, we can crop it, rotate it, or delete it. So you've got the ability to be able to modify the document if you need to after you've captured it. By the way, did you notice how quickly it captured? It doesn't always work as well and automatically define the parameters of the document. I found, depending on the background, most of the time it works that well, but the odd time it hasn't automatically parsed it out that way or figured it out, just as an aside. But once you got it, you can go in and you can edit the name of the document. I'm going to call this my demo doc so that we can see it once I save it into Evernote. So I'm going to save it as demo doc. There we go, demo doc. I don't think I want a demo doc. I want a demo doc. There we go. And there we go. Now, if I click on the little sharing tool below, it then, first of all, saves the document to Evernote for me automatically because that's how I've set it up my preferences. I'll show you the preferences in a moment. But now look at all the different options I have because when you scan in a document, sometimes you want to save it yourself to Evernote, but sometimes it's just a permission form that you have to send off to the school, or sometimes it's just a receipt that you have to send to somebody. So while you want it in Evernote yourself, or you probably want it in Evernote, often you're going to want to do something like mail it to somebody. So you just tap on the mail icon and it brings the document up and saves it. Now, single page documents, it automatically creates as JPEGs. So it's going to save it as JPEG. If you scan in a multi-page document, it will save it as a PDF. Those are presets in the software, so you can't change that, but this is going to send it as a JPEG, I believe, to whoever that is that we're sending it to. You can also instantly message it by using the message tool. You can obviously, if you haven't got it set up to save to Evernote right away, you can save it to Evernote. You can save it to your camera roll, or you can export it into whatever services that you happen to have set up. Now, I haven't set up very many services on this phone yet, but if I'd set up my Dropbox account or my Google Drive, I would have had the access to those in the export. But this is only my second day with the phone. I'm just starting to set it up. And if we go into the more area, that brings up the iOS 8 sharing aspects, where we can be posting this to Twitter, Facebook. We can be doing a variety of different things with this document as we've got it. But now that we've saved it, let's just jump back over and let's take a look in Evernote itself so that we can see where it's come in. I'm just going to go into my notebooks here, and I'm going to go into my inbox. And hopefully we're going to see that right here in the inbox, the scan that we just brought in. Let's sync it. And there's the note. Yep, indeed. So there's the note that we just captured. As you can see, it's nice and clear. And over time, Evernote will, of course, go through and it will pull all of the text out of this, which is just awesome. So this is super clean for capturing documents, but it does more than just capture documents. Let me jump into it and let me show. Actually, let's do this first. Let's go over into the settings. So I'm going to go back and I'm going to go into the settings for the app. So I just tapped on the gear icon to bring up the settings, and we have the Evernote link happening here. So you can have it automatically saved to Evernote. You can choose which notebook you want to save things to in Evernote, and you can change this on the fly. If you're scanning in a bunch of receipts and you want to change the default notebook from the inbox to your accounting notebook, you could set this here. But it also, if we scan down, it does two things that I think are quite interesting. First, it will also link to your calendars. So I haven't tested this out, but what they say it will do is it will actually look at who you have appointments with in your calendar, and it will automatically create sharing of documents that you scan in with other people in the calendar. So if you've got a meeting booked and you're taking pictures of the whiteboard, it'll automatically share those pictures with, or those images, those scans, with the people in the meeting. Kind of interesting, could be problematic, but it's an interesting option. Far more interesting is the LinkedIn connection. So this is similar to what we've got built into Evernote, where when you scan in a business card, it'll automatically connect it to LinkedIn. And let me show you that. I'm going to go back to done. And now it's just, I've pulled up a business card. Look how quickly it finds the business card. And you can do this even if you're holding it. It then takes the business card, goes in, and look, it's found Jordan already in LinkedIn, and is all set to connect me to Jordan, copy all of the information into my address book. This is that LinkedIn connection between the address book and scanning in business cards, and it is on a different level. You see how it performed here. It was just almost instantaneous. So there it's created the link, and it's created the connection in LinkedIn with Jordan. The other thing that I really like about this is using it for this purpose here, and I'm gonna just pull up one other document, and it's a receipt. I love using this for receipts. So it's just looking for it. No, it found too much of it. Let me see if I can find it. There it is. Boom. It so quickly captures it, focuses it, and then brings that document in where we can now open it, save it to Evernote, give it a name. Now it's ready for us for whatever accounting purposes we need. I think when you're like me, where you travel a lot for a lot of speaking engagements and you want to capture receipts rather than carrying them in a bulky wallet, this is just a terrific way to proceed. Evernote Scannable. Oh, it's free, which is huge. And it seems to be performing on a spectacular level, right out of the box. They figured out all of the little things that you want to do with a scanning app. And I didn't even talk about one additional feature because I can't show it to you here. It will control the Evernote Edition Scan Snap. So the Fujitsu Scan Snap, you can actually talk to with the app, and multiple people in a team can talk to the same scanner. And so you can have it scanning documents through this scanner, through a physical scanner, directly into your smartphone for connection to Evernote. So you've got some really nice integration built in. But as far as I'm concerned, right out of the gate, that ability to just be able to focus on a document, to be able to not have to define it and poke and do all of the cropping yourself, but it looks for the parameters of the document, focuses on, scans it, snaps it automatically for you, and then lets you make changes afterwards, but it assumes that it's doing it correctly. Just awesome. Straight out of the gate, awesome. It had me at, do you want to save this to Evernote? It's just a great, simple, free app that might change the way that you capture documents. And for me, it replaces, I moved over my smartphone from the iPhone 4S to this new iPhone 6 Plus just yesterday. This is one of the first apps that I installed. When I did that, I didn't even bother installing any of the other 5 or 6 scanning apps that I've purchased over the years because I don't think I'm going to need them anymore. I hope you found this video today to be useful. There are 3 ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. First, please subscribe to this channel. Second, subscribe to our newsletter. Then you can hear about all of our great upcoming webinars. And we have some awesome webinars coming down the pipe. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded channel. We are supported through you, our friends at Patreon. If you want to take a look at what's involved in becoming a patron of Dotto Tech and the perks that are included, and the perks are awesome, have a click and take a look at our Patreon page. Till next time, I am Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.